Yo, I'm back. Trying to get this fuel line threaded in here before I forget. I'll just come up out of there. Yeah, I know. I could have cut it off. Why make it easy? All right. Honestly, I thought it would thread through there easier. Prove me wrong, huh? Honestly, I meant to put this in before I put the cases together. Yeah, you always forget something. I do anyway. I always forget something. That should seal up without putting anything on it, but I'm going to anyway. Because, you know, I like to get silicone all over me. I like to do. I should want to twist that way. Spin it right in there until it gets tight. Probably should have done that before I put the flywheel on, eh? That might have been the smart thing to do. That one has to be done with pliers. It won't fit in there. No. No bueno. Hold on a second. Right tool for the job. I think it's tight. Like a tiger. Now, how long do I need my fuel line? That is that one. I'll throw another piece here. Alright. It's gotta be at least that long, but probably. We're going to take a guess. Take a swing at it. filter. I think I do. I think I have some HIPAA filters. Imagine that. Funny thing is, I actually bought these. That was before the... That was before getting to know Miss Nina. I'm going to hit her up for some because I only got one left. Oh boy, this is never going to go in this line. Oh man. Never have the right stuff. Almost get it there. Something goes wrong. Oh boy. Hold on. When in doubt, just a little bit. That's all it takes. Just a little bit of heat. Right on there. Now is it long enough? Yeah, boy. Sitting on the bottom. That's good enough for me. One more thing down. Piece by piece, she gets a little closer. I need a gasket for that reed cage. She's snappy. Do you want to be a P40 farm saw? Pattern for a reed gas, a reed cage. Hold on. This gasket's in good shape. I'm gonna put a little ultra copper on it and send it. Actually, this reed cage has got a little crack in it. Only one side. That's a pretty dang good one. Yeah. I'm gonna try that one. Thank you. Can't get these reed cages no more, so. This is how I fix them. I just put silicone in them. Just fill the crack up. That's about all you can do. If somebody starts making them again, which is probably never going to happen. This is one of the best ones I've seen. I don't have any. Don't have a crack in it. I don't know if you can see in there. Right there above that bolt hole. See the orange silicone line? Usually they're cracked to the outside too. That one's not. So we're definitely using this one. I mean, they don't always leak either. I had this one in his saw, was mine. And it's cracked bad. Both sides. Clear through the bolt hole. That's out of a farm saw. Run fine, and I know air leaks. But the one that came in this saw, I could not get it to stop leaking air. For whatever reason. These are fun saws to work on. They're a simple, simple saw. Ain't like no dang McCulloch, I can tell you that. These things are aliens. Work just fine, fine, fine. Can't wait to get this thing running. Kind of excited. I went a little hotter with this one than I did my farm saw. I know how well it runs. I'm excited. There shouldn't be no air leak there. I wouldn't think so. It's gonna be nice. It's gonna be nice. Wonder if Andrew's got a bucking spike for this. This saw has never had one on it. They're still painting the threads. It's weird. I've got a lot of farm saws that didn't have them on it. I gotta have a bucking spike. Well, this is gonna be an awesome saw. For sure. I can't wait. Alright, y'all, we're gonna shut her down. Come back later for some more assembly. Later, y'all.